Hey Watson, while reading up amino acids, I found something like this. What do the D and L mean? Does that mean amino acid from ducks and amino acid from lion?
Well, they are not amino acid from ducks or lions. Mm-hmm. D and L are what we say as enantiomers or mirror images. They are basically two compounds that look almost similar to each other, but they actually are not the same.
Mirror images? Like how?
Well, to understand that, let's do a simple test. Please take out your hands. Mm-hmm. So our left hands and our right hands look similar, but when we try to overlap them, they can never overlap with each other.
That's right.
This is what we say as enantiomers.
Oh, that's interesting. So one of my hand is a duck, and one of my hand is a lion.
No, your hands are not duck and lions. So to understand that, we need to take a look of D-alanine and L-alanine. D-alanine and L-alanine here. So when we try to overlap them, as you can see, it cannot be overlapped. Can you see that?
Mm-hmm. How about you try rotating them?
Well, we can try to rotate them. But as you can see, even if I rotate it, it still don't look the same. Can you see that? For both of the hydrogens are this side, but the nitrogen for this one is here, and the nitrogen for this one is here.
Uh-huh.
So they don't overlap. Mm-hmm. And this is what we say as enantiomers.
That's interesting. But how can we know which one is a duck and which one is the lion?
So for us to know which one is a duck and which one is a lion amino acid, we will need to look at corn method.
Corn? You mean this corn?
No, not that corn.
You mean this corn then?
Not that corn either. The corn method here is this corn method.
Okay.
So corn method is actually a short form from this corn. Corn is a short form from COOH, R from any group that is not denoted, and N from nitrogen group. And this is a short form corn.
Oh, so I can use corn to figure out which one is the duck and which one is the lion.
Okay, so let's take D isomer as an example. First thing first, the hydrogen here is pointing towards you. Remember that, that's okay. The first rule. Mm-hmm. And then with this as the point, this, the first one is the COOH, the second is here, R, corn, and the next one is nitrogen. So when you do this, what is this motion?
This is anti-clockwise.
So if it is an anti-clockwise, we name it D-isomer.
Oh, let me try this one.
Okay.
So the hydrogen point toward me, mm-hmm. and we have the CO group here.
Yep.
And then the R group here.
Yes.
And then the amino group here.
Yes.
So it would turn this way.
So what is this motion?
This one is clockwise direction.
Yeah.
So it would mean?
It is the L isomer.
Oh, that's interesting. So anti-clockwise is the duck and clockwise is the lion.
Okay, what are you guys doing?
Watson is just teaching me how to use corn to distinguish between a duck and lion.
Well, it's not duck and lion amino acids, it's D and L amino acids.
Okay, let's do some practice. So what about this? What is this? This is a phenylalanine. If you remember, the single letter code of the phenylalanine is F. So this is definitely the phenylalanine. But which one is it? D or L?
Maybe it's D phenylalanine? Mm.
Really?
Why?
Is it because the hydrogen is pointing the back and then this is CO, and this is R, and this is N, and so it's turning this direction?
Mm. This direction is anti-clockwise.
So that's D amino acid. Mm.
But the hydrogen in this case is pointing into the pages. Huh? So it's not pointing toward you.
Really?
So it should be the other way around. So this one should be L.
Which one?
Yeah, correct. So then you have to, you have to look at this structure from behind of the screen. So you have to look at the structure this way. So then, corn is this way. So corn is this way, so that's L.
Uh-huh.
So this is L phenylalanine. Mm. Okay, that's a good practice.
So you learn fast.
Okay.